Okay, we're working on our pistons here for the flathead motor. So we have these new ones here we're using. So I got to do the final hone on the cylinders now that they're all coated. So looking through the information here, we found that they want 3 thou clearance. And they're going to measure them right here at the tip of the piston, right down here at the very tip. So piston manufacturers measure things at different spots. You got to see what they recommend where to measure from. So that's where they're making them down at that point. Scooby, you're in my way. All right, so you're in charge of camera now. All right, so our cylinders we got coated. So we got a little bit of overcoating inside the bore, plus I never finished honing them. And we got to rehone the valve guide hole. There's some coating in there too. We spent a couple different weekends doing sanding, getting the surfaces all nice and flat here. And we also did the heads down here in the box. Got these nice and flat also. So, they're all good. There's the other cylinder down there. All right, so I already measured these things here, right at the tip down here. So this is a half on the mic, and this is 3/4. So we got a 1/4 thou different in 2 sizes. So we're gonna go ahead and check those out. So there you go. So the piston is supposed to be, the cylinder is supposed to be 804. And if you take this number, put 3.5 thou to it, we should be at 804. Even though they recommended 3. And we're at the cylinder right now. We were down here, I think, wasn't it? So right now our cylinder is, we're doing our mock-up with about 1/2 thou clearance, 3/4 of a thou. And we had a nice tight clearance when we're doing our mock-ups. We're probably going to have to shorten this piston up a little bit too because we did a bunch of sanding. Okay, so this one here was basically our half number right there. So you go 1/2, 1, 2, and 3. This is way up there at 4 on the dial, which is way more what they were claiming they wanted to be. See, that's where it sticks out, see? So this one here is the light rig, see it, 5. So we do 5 on this cylinder, which is our rear. And this one here, we go 1/4 thou bigger. Or I can tighten up by 1/4 and make this one 5 and make this one 4 3/4. So we'll make a decision on that. All right, we'll be back in a minute. First, we got to hone out the valve guides. Things are heavy. Why are you so heavy? Everything's getting worn out to the point it doesn't work anymore.
I know the feeling.
You've had that before. Damn, I thought about backwards. Oh, it's way over here, I wonder. So that should be the right stone. No workus. This one's a little bit fatter.
Doesn't like being there.
No, it's getting worn out. Everything is not working like it should anymore. You have a range of what these things are good for, and I'm pretty much maxed out my ranges because everything's worn out. Go bigger, it pops out. Thing. Look into a dark black hole, you can't see anything.
Do you want a valve?
Nope. Just want to see if the hole is cleaned up. Tip, it looks okay. Let's see, 5/16. So you gotta make sure that goes on, see? Yeah. Okay. You dropped the stone again. Getting spoiled over there. Bang my finger. All right, those look good.
Yeah, I know you don't get any.
See how the stone stays put.
Now it's going to stay in there.
Yeah, I want to take it out. Now it stays in. Oh, everything's just getting worn out around here. So these things work to a certain range of sizes, and 5/16 is about the top of the range. And this whole thing's been worn away so much over the years, it's way underneath what it was stock. So it's probably worn 15, 20 thou off this edge, which means you got to overextend the other side, and it just gets to the point. These here are on a taper, and they just
pops off the end of the wedge and pops it out. There's a big spring in that thing to hold it. Just getting time to buy some new stuff again. Or just go over that drawer over there and grab another new one.
There you go.
Oh well. It's all part of doing the job. Okay, now we're gonna hold the cylinders. Holding the guys was not what we had planned, or I didn't plan. Holding the cylinders was. What are you doing over there, Scooby? He's just getting spoiled over there, is all that is. Okay, so we got 3,000 to go. Oh, spider getting pissed off back there. Anymore. Okay, these are the finishing stones. See, when the stones get worn out for pandas and stuff, you use them for 45s. So you go big twin down to Sportster to down to 45. See how they get worn out? Now the perfect size for flatheads, it's small. Problem is, these are all. Looks like they're all 500 stones. That's a 300. This set will work. And I guess some real coarse ones over there, it looks like, too, maybe. Can't tell. We're going to use these. See, if you had a brand new set of stones, couldn't put the motor together. You couldn't put the cylinder on it. Too small. Right at the limit. Just make it. That would just make it probably. See how tall the stone is?
Oh yeah.
So you multiply that by two, that's why you run out of room. So you have to use worn out stones. There's always ways of cheating. Coming for you, Scooby. Oh, he's passed out now down there. Scooby's having a rough life down there. All right, so we got to take out 3,000 or so. 2,500. That last?
Not after we sanded it.
Uh-huh. cylinders are pretty hard too. They might be age hardened, you think?
Yeah.
Carbide won't even touch it here. Shedding across the surface.
4 years older than I am, at least.
It is? Yeah. It's more than that for me.